Hello all, this is Mohammad Anif. Once again, I welcome you to this lab session on subject digital signal processing. Today, we'll be writing a program for a band pass filter. And we'll be writing this band pass filter using the code which already we have defined for FIR low pass filter. So I request you to please go through my previous videos on FIR low pass filter, as we are going to use the entire code which we have written in that low pass filter, and then we'll do small changes as whenever we need a small modifications in that program to make it a band pass filter. Okay, so this is the program which is used for low pass filter. So I am copying the same program. And then pasting it to a new file, and then we'll go through this code, and whenever we need a small change or any changes, then we'll make that modification. Okay, so here it is starting with this three commands: clc, clear all, and close all, and then asking for entering the sampling frequency. So this will be our sampling frequency. And then this is TS upon FS will gives you a sampling period. Okay. And as we are supposed to design a band pass filter, so that band pass filter will consist of two cutoff frequencies. Namely, there will be a one lower cutoff frequency, and then we'll be having one upper cutoff frequency. So here you can see that in line 6, it is defined for low pass cutoff frequency. So it will have only one cutoff frequency here. But in today's program, as we need two cutoff frequencies, we'll make a change here. Okay. So first change here is that we have to define two cutoff frequencies. So this will be lower cutoff frequency, and then naming this as FL, or you can say lower cutoff FL, and then copying this and pasting here, and then we have to define higher cutoff frequency. So taking FCH for higher cutoff or upper cutoff frequency. Okay, this and this one will be FH. Okay, and then now here you can see that omega c is used for equivalent digital cutoff frequency for a low pass filter. And here, as we do have two cutoff frequencies, so we'll be having two equal digital cutoff frequencies. So one will be omega c l. Okay, so this is defined as 2 pi fc l upon fs. So copying this and pasting it one more time, so that we can have a second equivalent digital cutoff frequency, and it will be defined as 2 pi FCH upon FS. Okay, so this will be for FL, and this will be for FH. Okay, and then one more thing we have to define here is that we need to know that center frequency for this band pass filter. So for that one, we are defining as omega c naught. Omega c naught is equals to, it will be the average of these two frequencies. So defining that omega c plus omega c h upon 2. So this is equivalent digital, or equivalent, or actually it is not equivalent, it is center frequency, right? And then we have to define one, as we are writing a program By using low pass filter, so we have to define one equivalent digital cutoff frequency in low pass filter. So that will be omega c is equals to omega c h and then minus omega c l upon 2. This is digital equivalent low pass cutoff frequency, right? Okay, so then this will be the same window size, and then H we are defining the filter coefficients. This will used for filter coefficients. Okay, and this is the center of this L length, and then here we are defining one sync pulse for designing low pass filter, and here after this we are trying to make a figure here. So here we have to do we have to add one more line. Actually, you can see that from line 15 to 21 we have defined a sync pulse which will generate a low pass filter. So here H is consist of filter coefficients for low pass filter. Okay, so we have to convert this filter coefficients of low pass filter to band pass filter. Okay, so for that one we do have one conversion code. So this is the code that, so you can see that filter coefficients of low pass filter can be converted into filter coefficients of band pass filter by making multiplication with 2 cos n omega naught. Okay, so we'll be typing the same thing here. So we'll type here as H. So using the same H and making changes in that one. Okay, so H now is equals to 2 into cos of omega C naught. So this omega naught is our center frequency. So that we have defined as omega c naught. Okay, so omega c naught and into n. So here n, as we are using in this index, so we have to include c also. Okay, so n minus c plus 1, and then this will be multiplied with our previous filter coefficients of H, which is defined with low pass filter. So we'll write just H here. Okay, and this is conversion of LPF into band pass filter. Okay, and then using first figure, which defines stem and H, means defining with N and this H. So we'll be having one impulse response for band pass filter. So that is casual impulse response of FIR band pass filter. Okay, and then using the same thing, and then we are trying to define in magnitude response of DFT for this same band pass filter. Okay, and then we are using a digital we are converting into digital cutoff frequency. So here you will be having 0 to 2 pi. So maximum will be maximum cutoff, maximum frequency allowed in digital will be 2 pi. So we are converting into that, and then we are using magnitude response of that one. So this will be band pass filter, and then we are converting into analog cutoff analog frequencies. So again, so this will be magnitude response in equivalent analog. So for these sections, please please go through my previous video, as I want to make it short in time. So that's why I'm not explaining it completely. So I request you, and I recommend you to go through my previous video on FIR low pass filter. Okay, now from line 53, now here we are defining two signals. Okay, so one is F1, so entering for the first signal frequency x1, and then asking for f2 to make a second signal frequency. Then we are defining a two we are generating two sine waves, and we're assigning it to namely x1 and x2. Okay, so x1 will consist of frequency f1, and then x2 will consist of frequency f2, and then we are adding these two signals, okay, and assigning it to x. Then we are using y1, y2, y as filter outputs for respectively for x1, x2 and x, okay, and writing that filter operation here using convolution program. So you know, as I said here, so y1 will be having the output filter output for x1, and y2 will be having the filter output for x2, and y will be having the output filter output for x, which is a combination of x1 and x2. So that we have written here. So these are filtering using convolution. Okay, so here you will be y1 will having filter output for x1. So similarly, this y2, this is also filtering operation here, and y of n are also having filter operation. So now after this one, using figure 3, I'm trying to draw all the plots. So here we'll try to plot x1, x2, x, and y1, y2, y. So totally we need 6 plots here. So that's why taking a subplot and making into 6 divisions. So here you can see that 3 rows and 2 columns. So 6 plots will be there. So first plot is assigned to define x1. So this will be an input signal of x1, and then defining the second plot, which is a y1, so it will be band pass output of input signal x1. Similarly, third is a x2, and then fourth will be the band pass filter output for input signal x2, and then fifth one is the combination of input signals x1 and x2, and then sixth one will be band pass output filter. So that's it. This is the program for band pass filter. Just you can see that we have made changes here, that first we have defined 2 cutoff frequencies, and then 2 digital cutoff equivalent digital frequencies, and then we have defined a center frequency, and then equivalent digital frequency for low pass cutoff frequency, and then we made one more change here to convert low pass into band pass filter. Okay, now we'll try to run this program. So running the program, it is asking for sampling frequency, so giving 8000. So as a sampling frequency is 8000, the allowed cutoff frequencies will be not more than 4000. So first here it's asking for lower cutoff frequency, so I'm giving here 1000, and asking for upper cutoff frequency, so I'm going with 2500. So make sure that it shall not cross more than 4000. Okay, so it has to be below the 4000 only. Okay, now asking the window size 51. You can see that this is the impulse response for band pass filter. Okay, and then here you can see that this is the response for band pass filter. You can see that this is a digital equivalent frequencies. Okay, and then this is analog frequencies. So here you can see that, as we have mentioned, first cutoff frequency as 1000 and second as 2500. So here you can see that. Okay, now next it is asking for define the frequency. So now we will be defining frequencies for x1. So we have to choose frequencies in such a way that one frequency will lies in this band pass. So that is our band of 1000 to 2500. So one frequency will try to give in between this one, and one frequency will either give below to this or more than 2500. Okay, so first signal, let's say I'm going with 500. So this, that means it is out of the band. Okay, and next we'll try to give inside the band, so that is like 1500. Okay, now you can, these are the filter outputs. Now as you see that the first x1 signal, the frequency we have given is 500, and the x1 is having the amplitude of 1, and after this is the filter output for x1. So y1 is assigned for output of filter output for x1. Here you can see that the gain of this one is reduced. That means it is attenuated. Okay, and then x2 we have defined with 1500 frequency, and here you can see that amplitude is having 1. The same 1 amplitude is having here. That means it is allowed in the band and with the same amplitude. So there is no attenuation for this second signal x2. And next we have used this one. We have defined x as a combination of x1 and x2. So this is one combination of these two signals, and then output of this one will be yn, which is consist of 1500. So this is whatever the signal is given here, the same is signal here. So these two are similar. That means so second signal is as it lies between the band pass, so it is successfully allowed and it is available in the output. Okay, so I hope you have understand this. If any doubts, please comment in the make comments in the video. Okay, so that's it. Let's meet on this and next video. Okay, thank you.